Hi everyone and welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's session, I will bring to you the best questions from the month of June 2021. And today, in today's session, there will be 27 questions which are the best from the month of June. And remember, all these questions are exam oriented. These have the high chances of for asking in the exam. And at the end of the session, remember you have to comment your marks. Jaise aapne pichle session mein bahut acche se comment kiye the apne answers. उसी तरीके से आपको इस सेशन के एंड में यू हैव टू कमेंट ऑल योर मार्क्स इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन विदाउट एनी डिले. बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन. यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेस एंड अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग द डेली सेशंस एंड ऑल्सो रिगार्डिंग द कोर्सेज. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. एंड गाइज, यू हैव टू आंसर. अपना आंसर आप मार्क करते रहो, अपने आंसर आप देते रहो. एंड आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द न्यूज एंड देन विल टेल यू द आंसर. So you have to consider the following statement with regard to UA scheme for mentoring young authors and author mentorship program. So UA scheme launched with by the government of India. So what is this? Remember, UA stands for young upcoming and versatile authors. Do remember the full form. That's very important because it is a very short full form that can be asked in your exam. So UA stands for young upcoming and versatile authors, and this is basically an author mentorship program under which the new and the budding mentors, the budding authors will be provided training by the mentors. And remember, all these authors will be below 30 years of age. The training will be provided to the authors who are below 30 years of age. All right. And rupees 50,000 scholarship will be provided to the selected authors for a period of 6 months. And this is per month scholarship. Remember this. 50,000 scholarship per month will be provided for a period of 6 months to the selected authors. And the implementing agency, guys, for this scheme is the National Book Trust. National Book Trust India is the implementing agency for this scheme, and the book that will be published, that will also be translated into the regional languages of country, which will remark the Ek Bharat, which will represent in fact the Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat initiative of the government of India. Also remember, the published book under this initiative will be launched on 12th of January 2022. 12th of January 2022 ko usko launch karenge, because of course it is the National Youth Day, the birthday of the great Swami Vivekananda. All right. Now you have to identify the correct statement. So let's talk about the statement number one. UA stands for young ultimate and versatile authors. No. It is young upcoming and versatile author. And remember guys, some questions are exactly the same that we have done already, but some questions have been changed. The language of some questions have been changed. Okay, so kuch questions same hai because usme dusra koi question banana was not possible. So wo wale question bilkul exactly same hai, jaise ki ye wala question I hope aapko yaad hoga, is tarike ka same question humne kiya tha. And number two statement is the scholarship of rupees 50,000 per month will be provided. This is absolutely correct. Implementing agency of the scheme is not NCERT, it's the National Book Trust, which means we have only one statement which is correct here. And we have to identify the correct statement. All right, which means the options must be, let us say this option is only two. So option C should be the correct answer. All right. So option mein yahan pe galti ho gayi hai. Option C should be the correct answer. Let us say the option C is only two. Because we have to identify the correct statement and we have only one correct statement here. Let's move ahead to another question then. Which of the following is not correct regarding the PM Cares for Children scheme launched to support children who have lost their parents due to COVID-19. This is a very remarkable scheme of the government of India. And this has been launched to support those children who have lost their biological parents, their adoptive parents, their legal guardian due to COVID-19. Agar kisi child ke dono parent बायोलॉजिकल हो या फिर अडॉप्टिव पेरेंट हो या फिर लीगल गार्जियन हो, अगर वो उनकी डेथ हो गई है ड्यू टू कोविड, द सपोर्ट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड अंडर द स्कीम पीएम केयर्स फॉर चिल्ड्रन स्कीम. नाउ व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सपोर्ट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड, एंड रिमेंबर वन थिंग दैट दिस स्कीम विल बी फंडेड बाय द पीएम केयर्स फंड दैट वॉज लॉन्च्ड लास्ट ईयर. ओके, पीएम केयर्स फंड के थ्रू इसको फंडिंग दी जाएगी इस स्कीम को. नाउ व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सपोर्ट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अ कॉर्पस ऑफ ₹10 lakh, अ फिक्स डिपॉजिट ऑफ ₹10 lakh विल बी instituted in the name of the child, and out of this 10 lakh monthly stipend will be provided to the child after he or she attains the age of 18 years. 18 saal ke baad usko monthly stipend milne lagega for 5 years. Kab tak milega? 5 saal ke liye, up to the child has attained the age of 23 years and after the 23 years what will happen to this corpus? So it will be provided as a lump sum amount to the child, right? So corpus of 10 lakh will be created. Regarding educational thing, if the child is below 10 years of age, the admission in school in the nearest Kendra Vidyalaya or any private school will be provided, will be given to the student, and all the expenses will be borne by the government through the PM case fund. And if the child is admitted in a private school, the fees will be according to the right to education scheme, jo right to education mein minimum scheme lagti hai, and that fees will also be paid by the under this scheme through the PM cares fund. And other expenditure like uniform, textbook, notebook, that expenditure will also be provided by the government under this scheme. For children which are between the age group of 11 to 18 years, they will be provided admission in the central government residential schools, like we have Sainik schools, we have Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalayas, and they can also provide admission. They can also be given admission in the private schools as well, and there also the funding, the fees will be provided by the PM care in accordance with the right to education norms, right? And there is a provision of higher education also. The higher education loan will be provided to the students, to the child, if he wants to pursue the higher education. So higher education loan will be provided, and the interest for this will be provided through the PM cares fund, okay? And also remember, all the children who have lost their parents due to COVID-19 and who are the beneficiaries under the scheme, they will be enrolled as a beneficiary under Ayushman Bharat Yojana. Ayushman Bharat Yojana mein unko enrollment di jayegi. Okay, now you have to identify the incorrect statement. The scheme will be funded from PMK fund, absolutely correct. It is for those children only who have lost their both blood related parents. No, any kind of parent, whether it is adoptive parent, whether they are legal guardian, whether they are supporting parents. So if the child has lost any kind of parent, तो उनको ये beneficial इस scheme के अंदर benefit दिया जाएगा, alright? A corpus of 10 lakh for each child, yes, this is absolutely correct. All children will be enrolled as a beneficiary under Ayushman Bharat, and PM cares will also pay for expenditure on uniform, textbook and notebooks. This is also correct, which means option B will be the correct answer, alright? Option B will be the correct answer, because here you have to identify the incorrect statement. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. Name the portal which has been launched by National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, which works under the Ministry of Women and Child Development. And this ministry is headed by Smriti Irani, and her Lok Sabha constituency is of course Amethi, which is in Uttar Pradesh. And this portal for online tracking and digital real-time monitoring mechanism of children who lost both or either of their parents in COVID-19. So in the previous scheme, the PM cares for children scheme, the support will be provided to those children who have lost their parents due to COVID. But there should be a mechanism to identify those children, na? And for that identification, this portal was launched, and you have to identify the portal. So this portal, guys, is Bal Swaraj. Option A will be the correct answer here. Moving ahead to question number 4. In a pilot phase, the horticulture cluster development program will be implemented in dash horticulture clusters out of the total dash clusters selected for the program. So remember, this horticulture cluster development program has been launched by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. Narendra Singh Tomar is the minister, and this has been launched to develop the horticulture cluster in the country. Horticulture cluster ko develop karne ke liye this has been launched. And it will be in the pilot mode, it will be implemented in the 12 horticulture clusters out of total 53 horticulture clusters in the country. And what issues it will take into account? So all the issues related to the horticulture sector in our country, like pre-production issues, production issues, post-harvest issues, theek hai, iske alawa logistic issues will be covered, iske alawa marketing and branding issues will be covered. So all types of issues which are there in the horticulture sector will be covered under this new program, Horticulture Cluster Development Program. Also remember that it is estimated that ₹10,000 crore ka investment is estimated when the program will be implemented in all the 53 horticulture clusters. Alright. So here the correct answer should be 12 horticulture out of total 53, which means option A will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 5. Name the device that records real-time ambient temperature during the transportation of perishable products, vaccines and even body organs and blood, developed by IIT Ropar. So remember, this device has been developed by IIT Ropar under an innovation hub एक इनोवेशन हब है विद इन द IIT रोपड़. नाउ व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस इनोवेशन हब? इट इज अवध. इट इज व्हाट? अवध. एंड अवध स्टैंड्स फॉर एग्रीकल्चर एंड वाटर टेक्नोलॉजी डेवलपमेंट हब. एग्रीकल्चर एंड वाटर टेक्नोलॉजी डेवलपमेंट हब इज अ फुल फॉर्म ऑफ अवध. एंड द नेम ऑफ द डिवाइस गाइज इज MBTAG एंड इट कैन मेजर टेम्परेचर रेंजिंग फ्रॉम -40 degrees Celsius टू +80 degrees Celsius. सो इट विल बी वेरी हेल्पफुल इन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ पेरिशेबल प्रोडक्ट्स, वैक्सीन एंड इवन अदर बॉडी ऑर्गन्स एंड ब्लड. एंड इट विल डेफिनेटली सर्व इन दिस एरिया. ओके, सो MBTAG हेयर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. वन सेकेंड गाइज. यस, so now let's talk about question number 6. Which institute has been declared as the first standard developing organization under One Nation One Standard mission of Bureau of Indian Standard? So first of all, let's talk about what is the meaning of this One Nation One Standard mission. So remember, the Bureau of Indian Standard is implementing this mission One Nation One Standard. Now the name suggests, as the name suggests, that this mission is all about developing single particular standard for all the products for ensuring the quality products in the country. The basic idea behind this mission is to develop a single template for all the products, a single standard for all the products, and below that particular standard no product will be allowed for the manufacturing. Okay, so to develop a single standard, a bare minimum standard for a particular product, this mission was launched. And recently the Research, Design and Standard Organization of Indian Railways has been declared as the first standard developing organization under this mission. Now you must have a doubt can come in your mind that if we are developing all the items or all a particular product, if we are developing a particular product under a single standard, then how it will lead to the competitive pricing. Okay, ab ye dimag mein aapke aa raha hoga ki agar hum ek product ko ek hi standard ke sath develop karenge तो कॉम्पिटिटिव प्राइसिंग का क्या होगा? सो रिमेंबर गाइज, इट इज द मिनिमम स्टैंडर्ड. ओके, दिस वन स्टैंडर्ड मीन्स हियर इट इज द मिनिमम स्टैंडर्ड. बिलो दिस स्टैंडर्ड नो प्रोडक्ट विल बी अलाउड फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग वंस दिस स्कीम, वंस दिस मिशन इज इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन ऑल ओवर द कंट्री, इन ऑल ओवर द इन ऑल द डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स अक्रॉस द कंट्री. ओके, सो आई होप द डाउट इज क्लियर. एंड ऑप्शन बी, रिसर्च डिजाइन एंड स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ इंडियन रेलवेज इज द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑलराइट, question number 7 says, which of the following companies has launched Vajra Kavach disinfection system which can remove scourge of viral particles from equipment used by coronavirus frontline workers? So this is a very very innovative and very very important invention, important, you know, you can say important device, important system that can help removing the scourge of viral particles from the equipment that are being used by the medical workers, the frontline workers of corona. Okay, and it can remove the viral particles from N95 mask, it can remove it from the gloves, it can remove it from the gowns, it can remove from the PPE kit. So from everywhere it can remove the traces of viral particles. And this has been developed by Indra Water. Indra Water is the startup that has developed this Vajra Kavach disinfection system. And remember, this startup is it is at IIT Bombay. Yeah, IIT Bombay ke andar incubated hai. All right, let's move ahead to question number 8. Then consider the following statement with regards to Model TNC Act and identify which are not correct. So Model TNC Act, remember guys, it has been approved by the Union Cabinet and it was drafted by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Housing and Urban Affairs. And who is the minister? It's Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri. Hardeep Singh Puri is the Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs and he is the Rajya Sabha MP. And this basically a model for the TNC Act, and the states आर फ्री टू डेवलप देयर ओन एक्ट. बेसिकली ये क्या है, एक आइडिया है, ये एक मॉडल है, और इस मॉडल के बेसिस पे स्टेट्स कैन डेवलप देयर ओन एक्ट. ऑलराइट, ऑल्सो रिमेंबर दैट देयर आर सम वेरियस इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोविजंस अंडर दिस मॉडल टेनेंसी एक्ट, लाइक देयर शुड बी एन अग्रीमेंट बिटवीन द देयर मस्ट बी एन अग्रीमेंट इन फैक्ट बिटवीन द लैंड ओनर्स एंड द टेनेंट्स. एंड इसके अलावा इट ऑल्सो टॉक्स अबाउट द सिक्योरिटी डिपॉजिट. It also talks about the security deposit for commercial building, or you can say for the commercial area, the maximum security deposit can be for the 6 months, can be the 6 months rent, while for the residential it can be maximum 2 months rent. Iske alawa the repairing for the basic structural damage like painting on the walls, replacing the doors, replacing the windows, all will be done बाय द लैंडलॉर्ड्स, वाइल द छोटे मोटे रिपेयर्स, जो छोटे मोटे रिपेयर्स होते हैं लाइक सॉकेट खराब होना या फैन खराब हो जाना या मोटर खराब हो जाना, सो ऑल विल बी, ऑल दीज थिंग्स विल बी डन बाय द टेनेंट्स. ऑलराइट, एंड इफ द लैंडलॉर्ड वांट्स टू रिवाइज द रेंट, ओके, इफ ही और शी वांट्स टू रिवाइज द रेंट, देन ही हैज टू गिव अ 3 months एडवांस नोटिस फॉर दैट. ऑलराइट, सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोविजंस ऑफ दिस एक्ट. एंड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द statements. The draft act had been published by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. This is absolutely correct. It is mandated for the state to enact it without any change. No, they can make certain changes according to the local conditions. And according to the act, maximum limit for security deposit for commercial purpose premise is 6 months. This is absolutely correct. While for the residential purpose, it is 2 months. So 1 and 3 are correct here, but we have to identify the incorrect. Only 2 options C will be the correct answer. All right. Question 9 says, the government of India has dedicated a window, the green gold collection, on the GeM portal for the marketing of DASH. GeM stands here for the green, for the government e-marketplace. And if you know the, if you know which commodity is known as the green gold, then you can easily answer this question. The bamboo is known as the green gold, which means the correct answer to this question will be bamboo goods. And this green gold collection window will be developed on the government e-marketplace portal. And it has been done obviously to promote the use of bamboo goods ke use ko promote karne ke liye this has been done. And on this window, all the bamboo goods, all the handcrafted bamboo goods will be showcased, and from there the buyers can buy their products related to bamboo goods. Okay, so the correct answer is what? Bamboo goods, option A. And question number 10 says, how much fund has been allocated by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment for financial year 2022 for the implementation of SAGE initiative? Now, SAGE initiative has been launched by this ministry. Remember, this ministry is headed by Mr. Thawar Chand Gehlot is the minister, and SAGE stands for Senior Care Aging Growth Engine. Senior Care Aging Growth Engine is the full form of SAGE, and this initiative is for helping those entrepreneurs who wants to do entrepreneurship, who wants their entrepreneurship in the field of services provided to the elderly persons. If any person, if any entrepreneurs wants to develop his idea, his startup into the area of services provided to the elderly care, then this initiative will provide to that entrepreneur. All right. And 25 crore funding will be provided in this financial year 2021, and maximum 1 crore funding will be provided to each startup. Okay, ek startup ko 1 crore rupay maximum diye jayenge for developing their product. All right. And the ministry, what will be the role of ministry then? So the ministry will act as a facilitator to the elderly person to provide them access to the services that is being developed by these startups. Okay. एंड ये जो पोर्टल होगा, इसके एक पोर्टल डेवलप किया जाएगा विच विल बी नोन एज सेज पोर्टल. इस पोर्टल के थ्रू द सीनियर सिटीजन्स, द एल्डरली पर्सन कैन एक्सेस ऑल द सर्विसेज दैट इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड बाय अ पर्टिकुलर स्टार्टअप. ऑलराइट, सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट, ऑप्शन ई, रुपीज 25 करोड़ फंडिंग विल बी प्रोवाइडेड फॉर द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2022. एंड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, विच इज अबाउट द वर्ल्ड एनवायरमेंट डे दैट वॉज ऑब्जर्व ऑन 5th of June. 5 जून वर्ल्ड एनवायरनमेंट डे हर साल मनाया जाता है, इस साल भी मनाया गया. एंड रिमेंबर द यूनाइटेड नेशन थीम वॉज इकोसिस्टम रिस्टोरेशन वॉज द यूनाइटेड नेशन थीम. एंड इंडिया थीम वॉज प्रमोशन ऑफ बायोफ्यूल्स फॉर अ बेटर एनवायरनमेंट. राइट, प्रमोशन ऑफ बायोफ्यूल्स फॉर अ बेटर एनवायरनमेंट. एंड इंडिया Prime Minister Narendra Modi has made some announcement on this day, World Environment Day. Like, for example, the target of achieving 20% ethanol blended petrol has been preponed to the year 2025. Earlier this target was 2030, but now it has been preponed. Okay, 2025 तक हमें 20% ethanol blended petrol का इस्तेमाल पूरे देश में करना है. Alright. इसके अलावा 1E100 पायलट प्रोजेक्ट वॉज लॉन्च इन पुणे फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द इथेनॉल. दिस इज E100 बेसिकली अ प्योर इथेनॉल. ओके, सो दिस पायलट प्रोजेक्ट, E100 पायलट प्रोजेक्ट हैज बीन लॉन्च इन पुणे फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग ऑफ प्योर इथेनॉल अक्रॉस द कंट्री. एंड इसके अलावा द गवर्नमेंट विल इशू एन E20 नोटिफिकेशन. एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस नोट, एज पर दिस नोटिफिकेशन, the government will allow the oil companies to sell the 20% ethanol blended petrol from 1st of April 2023. 1st April 2023 के बाद से they can sell the E20 ethanol, they can sell the 20% ethanol blended petrol. Alright. Now you have to identify the correct statements. So India's theme for World Environment Day was ecosystem restoration. No, India's theme was promotion of biofuels for better environment. This ecosystem restoration was the theme of United Nation. Target of achieving 20% ethanol blended petrol in India has been postponed. No, it has been in fact preponed by 5 years. E100 pilot project has been launched in New Delhi. No, it was launched in Pune. So all the statements basically are incorrect here. So all are incorrect should be the correct answer. All right, option E. And let's move ahead to question number 12, which is about the Surakshit Hum Surakshit Tum Abhiyan. In 112 aspirational districts, so the question is, Niti Aayog has launched Surakshit Hum Surakshit Tum Abhiyan in 112 aspirational district with collaboration of Piramal Foundation. The answer to this question is what? Piramal Foundation is the correct answer. And remember, this program, Surakshit Hum Surakshit Tum Abhiyan, is to assist the administration in providing home care support to the patients of COVID-19. जो COVID-19 के पेशेंट्स हैं उनको होम केयर सपोर्ट दी जा सके उसके लिए एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन को असिस्टेंस प्रोवाइड कराई जाएगी अंडर दिस प्रोग्राम एंड इट हैज बीन डन बेसिकली टू रिड्यूस द प्रेशर ऑन द मेडिकल सिस्टम जो मेडिकल सिस्टम है उसके ऊपर प्रेशर रिड्यूस करने के लिए दिस हैज बीन डन दिस हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड एंड वी ऑल नो कि मेडिकल सिस्टम के ऊपर कितना ज्यादा प्रेशर आया था ड्यूरिंग द सेकेंड फेज ऑफ COVID-19 सो ऐसे केसेस जो कि घर पे ही ट्रीट किए जा सकते हैं सो ऑल दोज केसेस विच कैन बी ट्रीटेड एट होम And for that home care support, this program has been launched to assist administration. Okay. And this will be done with the help of thousands of NGOs and volunteers will be provided training that how they can provide home care support to the COVID-19 patients. Okay. So Piramal Foundation is the correct answer to this question. Option A. Moving ahead to question number 13, the very, very important question. Kahin na kahin pakka aayega paper mein QS World University rankings. Not correct statement you have to identify. So remember the 2022 edition was the 18th edition of the QS World University rankings. And these rankings guys are based on the 6 parameters. Hote isme, like international faculty ratio, international students ratio, faculty reputation, employer reputation, iske alawa faculty students ratio, citations per faculty. So these are the 6 parameters. And remember, you don't have to remember the name of all the parameters, just remember there are 6 parameters. Okay, just remember that there are 6 parameters. And once again, it was MIT USA which was at number one, and it has been at number one for the last 10 years. Number two paid was University of Oxford, while number three paid was University of Cambridge, and both of them are in UK. All right, and if we talk about the Asian institutions, so there were total 26 Asian institutions which are featured in the top 100. And among all the Asian institutions, Singapore National University was at number one. Singapore National University was at number one. While talking about the Indian institute, so 117 pe, it was IIT Bangalore. So from IIT Bombay, IIT Bombay was at rank number one from India side, but overall ranking, it was 177. IIT Delhi was at rank 185. While IISc Bangalore, Indian Institute of Science Bangalore, was at rank 186, and Jawaharlal Nehru University made its debut for the first time. Alright, so QS World University Rankings 2022 is the 18th edition, absolutely correct. MIT USA was ranked number 1, and 26 Asian institutions featured in the top 100. So all the statements are absolutely correct, which means none is incorrect should be the correct answer, option D. And now let's talk about question number 14. The Ministry of Labour and Employment announced the decision to extend the coverage under the Employees State Insurance Act 1948 to all the casual and contractual workers working in the DASH in the country. So remember, this act, ESIC Act 1948, has been extended to all the casual and contractual workers which are working in the municipal bodies. And by this, the social security net will be extended to all the casual and contractual workers who are working in the municipal bodies across the country. And all the benefits under the ESIC, like for example, sickness benefit, maternity benefit, disablement benefits that are being provided under the ESIC, that will now be also provided to all the casual and contractual workers which are working in the municipal bodies. So option A here is the correct answer. Question number 15, let's talk about this. India registered excellent growth in agriculture exports during this financial year, during the previous financial year. What is correct about the growth? Correct, हमें बताना है growth के बारे में. So remember, if you talk about in the terms of US dollars, so there was an increase of 17.34% and it was jumped to $41.25 billion. The agricultural exports jumped to a mark of $41.25 billion if you talk about in the terms of USA dollars. While talking about in the terms of Indian rupees, so there was an increase of 22.62% and it has been jumped to 3.05 lakh crores. Also remember the top three markets for India's agri export was USA number 1, China number 2 and Bangladesh was at number 3. Alright, number 1 pe USA, number 2 pe China and number 3 pe we have Bangladesh. Okay, so is news mein itna hi padhna, isse zyada mat padhna. इसमें हमने टेबल भी पढ़ी थी पूरी लंबी चौड़ी, बट दैट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द एग्जाम बिकॉज दैट विल बी टू यू नो बहुत सारे नंबर्स आ जाएंगे उसमें. सो इंडियाज एग्रीकल्चर एक्सपोर्ट इन यूएस डॉलर इंडिकेटिंग एन इंक्रीज ऑफ 17.3% एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. लार्जेस्ट मार्केट फॉर इंडियाज एग्री एक्सपोर्ट वॉज यूएसए करेक्ट. इंडियाज एग्रीकल्चर एक्सपोर्ट इन रूपी टर्म्स 22.62%. सो ऑल द स्टेटमेंट्स आर एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. So all are correct. Option D should be the correct answer because we have to identify the correct statement. And remember, correct or incorrect word पे ध्यान रखना यार. कभी कभी एग्जाम में confusion हो जाती है. Correct पूछा होता है incorrect mark कर देते हैं, या incorrect पूछा होता है correct mark कर देते हैं. So you have to focus on the what is being asked. The correct one is asked or the incorrect one is asked. Okay, so इसमें confused मत होना, वरना तो यार आता आता question गलत हो जाएगा और we cannot afford कि हम आता हुआ question भी गलत कर दें because we all know competition कितना ज़्यादा है. Now let's talk about question number 16. Which of the following is not correct about the deep ocean mission which has been approved by the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs? Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs ne deep ocean mission ko approve kar diya hai. Now what is the basic objective of this deep ocean mission? To naam se pata chal raha hai that they are going to explore the deep ocean, the deep sea. And now what, for what they are going to explore this deep sea? For studying the biodiversity there, for studying the impact of climate change there, and to establish an offshore marine station there. Okay, marine, ek offshore marine station bhi banaya jayega under this mission, deep ocean mission. And remember, the implementing ministry for this is the Ministry of Earth Science. Ministry of Earth Science, which is headed by Dr. Harshvardhan. Also remember that 4077 crore rupees has been provided for a period of 5 years for this scheme. And there are various components of this scheme which are not important. Just remember these 2-3 important facts about this scheme. Okay, so the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change is the nodal agency. No, estimated cost of the mission is 4077 crores. Absolutely correct. And it aims to study biodiversity and impact of climate change. So second or third statement correct hai, par hame incorrect statement identify karna hai. Option C should be the correct answer. Okay, अब आ जाओ क्वेश्चन नंबर 17 पे, जो मेडिकैब हॉस्पिटल्स के बारे में. स्टार्टअप डैश इंक्यूबेटेड एट IIT मद्रास डेवलप द मेडिकैब हॉस्पिटल्स विच आर नथिंग बट द फोल्डेबल हॉस्पिटल्स. मैंने आपको इसकी पिक्चर भी दिखाई थी. दीज आर द फोल्डेबल हॉस्पिटल विच कैन बी कंस्ट्रक्टेड विद इन मिनट्स, मिनटों में ये खड़ा हो जाता है. एंड दिस इज बेसिकली टू रिड्यूस द बर्डन ऑन द मेन हॉस्पिटल एंड टू क्रिएट अ वास्ट नेटवर्क ऑफ द हॉस्पिटल्स बिकॉज वी ऑल नो जो सेकेंड फेज था उसमें बहुत ज़्यादा कमी पड़ गई थी हॉस्पिटल्स में बेड्स की. सो दिस मेडिकैब हॉस्पिटल्स विल यू नो प्लग द गैप इन द मेडिकल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर सिस्टम. ओके, एंड दिस विल डेफिनेटली हेल्प इन द एक्सटेंशन ऑफ हॉस्पिटल. एंड रिमेंबर दिस हैज़ बीन डेवलप्ड बाय अ स्टार्टअप विच इज नोन एज मॉड्यूलस हाउसिंग. ऑप्शन डी, मॉड्यूलस हाउसिंग शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर. अब आ जाओ क्वेश्चन नंबर 18 पे. क्वेश्चन नंबर 18 है, व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ जेम सहाय ऐप दैट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री हेडेड बाय मिस्टर पीयूष गोयल. ही इज आल्सो द मिनिस्टर ऑफ रेलवेज. ये मिनिस्टर रेलवे के भी मिनिस्टर है भाई. हाँ जी, तो जेम सहाय ऐप का हमें पर्पस बताना है. सो रिमेंबर, जेम सहाय ऐप हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड टू प्रोवाइड अनकोलेट्रलाइज्ड कैश बेस्ड लोन्स. Uncollateralized cash-based loans to the medium and small enterprises. Okay, medium and small enterprises को uncollateralized. Uncollateralized का मतलब यार, I hope आपको पता है, जिसमें कोई collateral या कोई guarantee नहीं देनी पड़ेगी. Okay, और cash में होगा पूरा loan. Medium और small enterprises को दिया जाएगा. Okay, so it is a mobile app guys, basically for lending. Option A will be the correct answer. And this lending is to whom? Is to the medium and the small enterprises. Okay. Let's talk about question number 19 then, which is about the Vivatech. You have to identify the correct statement regarding Vivatech, whose fifth edition was held in the month of June 2021. Remember, it was in news because Prime Minister of India delivered the key address at this event of Vivatech and invited the world to invest in our country. हमारे देश में लोगों को इनवाइट किया उन्होंने कि आइए इंडिया में इन्वेस्ट करिए, इंडिया में पैसा लगाओगे तो बेटा बहुत मालामाल हो जाओगे, क्योंकि इंडिया में बहुत रिसोर्सेज हैं, बहुत कमाई के जरिए हैं. एंड ऑफ कोर्स वी आर इंप्रूविंग इन द ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस रैंकिंग एज वेल, जो कि वहां से भी पता चलता ही है. सो दिस वॉज इन न्यूज एंड रिमेंबर इट इज वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट डिजिटल एंड स्टार्टअप इवेंट्स ऑफ द यूरोप एंड इट इज हेल्ड एवरी ईयर in Paris from the year 2016, and during this events there are various events like exhibition is there, award function is there, discussion is there. Okay, so Vivatech is one of the largest digital and startup events in Europe. Absolutely correct. It is not the event that was held in India. It is an event of Europe and it is held every year in Paris from the year 2016. The event includes exhibition, awards, panel discussion and startup contest. Yes. And it is being held in Paris every year since 2016. So, sare statement correct hai. All are correct. All the statements are absolutely correct. Option D will be the correct answer. And moving ahead to question number 20, Ministry of Port, Shipping and Waterways and Ministry of Culture have signed an MOU for cooperation in the development of National Maritime Heritage Complex. Now, remember this National Maritime Heritage Complex, it will be developed at Lothal. Lothal in Gujarat, and Lothal we all know is an Asian site, Asian Harappan site, Indus Valley civilization mein site thi Lothal, and this will be developed to showcase the India's rich maritime heritage. India ki jo rich maritime heritage hai usko showcase karne ke liye this complex will be developed, and it will be developed as the international tourist destination as well. Okay. So therefore, the correct answer should be option C, Lothal in Gujarat. And for this, rupees 1500 crore rupees funding has been provided by the government to develop this. Okay. Now, question number 21. Let's talk about this. Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship has launched customized crash course program for COVID-19 frontline workers as the central component of one of its scheme. You have to name the scheme under which scheme this has been done. So remember, this has been done under the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, whose third edition is going on right now. And the basic objective of this customized crash course program is to provide training to the non-medical COVID frontline workers. And this has been done in view of the shortage, जो कि हमने अभी देखी थी second phase में shortage पड़ गई थी medical workers की. इतने सारे patients हो जाएंगे और patients को हॉस्पिटल दे दोगे, बेड दे दोगे, पर डॉक्टर कहां से दोगे? ऑलराइट. सो टू फिल दैट गैप द नॉन मेडिकल फ्रंटलाइन वर्कर्स विल बी प्रोवाइडेड ट्रेनिंग अंडर दिस स्कीम, प्रधानमंत्री कौशल विकास योजना 3.0. एंड ऑल द टाइप ऑफ ट्रेनिंग लाइक होम केयर सपोर्ट ट्रेनिंग, द बेसिक सपोर्ट ट्रेनिंग, द एडवांस सपोर्ट ट्रेनिंग, द मेडिकल इक्विपमेंट सपोर्ट ट्रेनिंग, द सैंपल कलेक्शन सपोर्ट ट्रेनिंग विल बी, सो ऑल द टाइप ऑफ ट्रेनिंग विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द non-medical frontline workers. Alright. So this has been done under the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. Option C will be the correct answer. And for this, 276 crore will be the estimated expenditure. Okay. Question number 22. Let's talk about this. Under which program, Department of Biotechnology has issued a special call for Northeastern region with an aim to understand the local problems of the Northeastern region farmers and provide them with the scientific solutions to those problems. So, इसका ये जो कॉल है, दिस स्पेशल कॉल, इसका ऑब्जेक्टिव इज ऑलरेडी गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. दिस इज फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द लोकल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन फार्मर्स एंड टू प्रोवाइड साइंटिफिक सोल्यूशंस टू देम. नाउ व्हाट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड लॉन्चिंग दिस? दिस इज बिकॉज द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन, द 70% वर्कफोर्स आर एंगेज इन द एग्रीकल्चर, बट देयर एग्रीकल्चर स्टाइल इज नॉट दैट एफिशियंट. एंड इन फैक्ट they are only producing 1.5% of the food grains that we grow across the country, that we grow in total across the country. And talking about the domestic consumption, if you're talking about their domestic consumption of food grains, they are the net importers. Matlab ki northeastern state jo hai wo apne liye bhi food grains ki production nahi kar pa rahe. Okay, So for these reasons, this special cause has been taken by the Department of Biotechnology under the Biotech Kisan program. Biotech Kisan program, guys, the basic objective of this program is to develop scientific solutions to the problems related to the agriculture and the agricultural productions. Okay, so option C here is the correct answer. Question number 23, which of the following app has been developed by Ministry of Ayush and WHO, which will help in spreading yoga world over and will contribute to the efforts of One World, One Health. So this was launched on 21st June. That was International Yoga Day, and the name of the app is what? M Yoga, and it was developed by Murarji Desai, National Institute of Yoga, which works under the Ministry of Ayush and WHO. And under this app, the training modules will be there. The audio sessions will be there. The video sessions will be there on the basic yoga protocol. And it has currently launched. It has been currently launched in English and Hindi. English and Hindi may be a launch hua hai, but it will in future will be launched in all the six languages of United Nations. United Nations ki jo 6 languages hai, un sabhi mein ye launch kar diya jayega. So M Yoga here is the correct answer. Question number 21-24 says, which ministry has launched the campaign Jaan Hai To Jahan Hai awareness campaign. So this campaign is basically for raising awareness about the COVID vaccination. COVID vaccination ke regarding awareness generate karne ke liye, this awareness campaign has been launched by the Ministry of Minority Affairs headed by Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi. And this will also create awareness. This will also basically remove the rumors that is being spread रिगार्डिंग द कोरोना वायरस वैक्सीन. ओके, जो र्यूमर फैला हुआ है हमारी सोसाइटीज में कि वैक्सीन लगाने से ये हो जाएगा वो हो जाएगा, तो इस तरीके के र्यूमर्स को हटाने के लिए दिस अवेयरनेस कैंपेन हैज बीन लॉन्च. और अगर आपके आसपास जो भी है, अगर कोई है, मैंने आपको पहले भी अपील करा था ये चीज़ का, अगर आपके आसपास भी कोई है जिसने अभी तक वैक्सीनेशन नहीं लिया है, या आप में से भी कुछ कलाकार ऐसे होंगे जिन्होंने अभी तक वैक्सीनेशन नहीं लिया होगा, तो प्लीज़ मेरे कलाकारों, जाओ और वैक्सीनेशन ले लो. वैक्सीनेशन नहीं लोगे तो उसके अलावा कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है आपके पास. ठीक है, अगर आप मेरे को ये रैशनल देते हो उसके पीछे कि सर वैक्सीनेशन तो अपने पूरे ट्रायल स्टेजेस से गुजरी ही नहीं है, तो माय डियर फ्रेंड, आपके पास कोई ऑप्शन भी नहीं है और पूरे ट्रायल से वो गुजर चुकी है. अगर उसको पूरे ट्रायल से नहीं गुजरी होती तो WHO की या जो हमारी मिनिस्ट्री ने उसको जो परमिशन दी है वो नहीं देते. और हमारी गवर्नमेंट इतनी पागल नहीं है जो 140 करोड़ लोगों की जान को स्टेक पे लगा दे, समझ रहे हो? तो ऐसा नहीं हो सकता है कि गवर्नमेंट इतनी बेवकूफ़ हो जाएगी. थोड़ा लॉजिकली सोचो और लॉजिकली लोगों के दिमाग में डालो कि ऐसा नहीं हो सकता कि गवर्नमेंट जो है वो 140 करोड़ लोगों को कंट्रोल कर लेगी विद द हेल्प ऑफ वैक्सीनेशन. दिस इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल. ओके, हम एक डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री के पार्ट हैं. ठीक है, तो यह यहाँ पर कोई राजा नहीं बैठा हुआ हमारे सर के ऑऊपर जो कि प्रजा के लिए जो भी चाहेगा वो कर लेगा. ऑलराइट, सो गो एंड वैक्सीनेट योर सेल्फ एंड लोगों को भी अवेयर करो अबाउट दी वैक्सीनेशन, अबाउट दी बेनिफिट्स ऑफ वैक्सीनेशन. ऑलराइट, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ माइनॉरिटी अफेयर्स इज द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन. एंड हाउ विल दिस अवेयरनेस बी डन? सो दिट विल बी डन थ्रू सम काइंड ऑफ एग्जीबिशन, थ्रू सम काइंड ऑफ सेमिनार्स, थ्रू सम काइंड ऑफ वेबिनार्स, थ्रू सम काइंड ऑफ वीडियो मैसेजेस फ्रॉम द फेमस पर्सनैलिटीज एज वेल. ओके, सो ऑप्शन ए हेयर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 25, वी कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट विद रिगार्ड्स टू टैक्स इंस्पेक्टर्स विदाउट बॉर्डर्स प्रोग्राम. ये तो अभी हमने परसों के सेशन में ही पढ़े हैं. सो टैक्स इंस्पेक्टर्स विदाउट बॉर्डर प्रोग्राम, इट वॉज द न्यूज बिकॉज भूटान इन पार्टनरशिप विद इंडिया हैज लॉन्च दिस प्रोग्राम. एंड फॉर अंडर दिस प्रोग्राम वॉट विल हैपन, इंडियन ऑडिटर्स विल प्रोवाइड ट्रेनिंग टू द भूटान ऑडिटर्स सो दैट देयर स्किल्स कैन बी एनहांस्ड एंड देयर टैक्स एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन कैन बी स्ट्रेंथन. ओके, this tax inspectors without border program, it is a joint initiative of UNDP and OECD, United Nations Development Program and OECD ka ye joint initiative, and the basic objective of this initiative is to sharing of the tax related information, tax audit related information across the countries, across the developing countries. Okay, so let's talk about the statements then. It is a joint initiative of UNDP and OECD. yes, the objective of this initiative is to enable sharing of tax audit knowledge and skills in developing countries. Correct. It is not a joint initiative of UNDP and World Bank. So 1 and 2 should be the correct answer, but incorrect identify karna hai. So only 3. Okay, only 3 is not there. Acha, okay, option B, only 3 will be the correct answer. Question number 26, the Ministry of Tribal Affairs headed by Arjun Munda and the NCERT recently collaborated on a joint mission for the Dash Capacity Building Program for a club by school teachers and principals. So अभी ये तो हमने अभी पढ़ा है परसों, ये तो आई होप आपको सबको याद होगा यार, ए क्लब बाय स्कूल टीचर्स एंड प्रिंसिपल के कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग प्रोग्राम के लिए. दिस प्रोग्राम इज निष्ठा, निष्ठा कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग प्रोग्राम फॉर ए क्लब बाय स्कूल टीचर्स एंड प्रिंसिपल. एंड विद दिस द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स हैज अ विजन टू प्रोवाइड टू अचीव इनफैक्ट द अकेडमिक एक्सीलेंस इन ऑल द क्लब बाय स्कूल. एंड इन द फर्स्ट बैच 120 school teachers and principals participated from three states of Himachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Okay, and the training was conducted in an online mode. And धीरे धीरे बाकी सभी states के club based school teachers को और principals को training will be provided. So Nishtha will be the correct answer, option A. And now question number 27, which is the last question for this session, guys. With which tech giant Ministry of Agriculture has signed an MOU for implementation of AgriStack? So this company is Microsoft. CEO is Satya Nadella and I was very happy. आप में से कई लोगों ने, बहुत सारे लोगों ने कमेंट किया था अपना आंसर. सो गाइज कमेंट करते रहा करो, जो भी क्वेश्चन मैं आप लोगों से पूछता हूँ, दैट वे मुझे पता चलता रहेगा दैट हाउ यू गाइज आर प्रिपेयरिंग, किस तरीके की प्रिपरेशन है आपकी. ओके देखो अब यहाँ पे क्या है कि हम वर्चुअली ही एक दूसरे से के साथ कॉन्टैक्ट में है. सो देर इज ओनली वन वे आउट टू कॉन्टैक्ट ईच अदर एंड दैट इज द कमेंट बॉक्स ऑफ यूट्यूब. अगर वो भी खाली रह जाएगा तो यार फिर कैसे एक लिंक बनेगा आप में और मेरे में, राइट? समझ रहे हैं? सो माइक्रोसॉफ्ट हियर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड रिमेंबर व्हाट इज द AgriStack, इट इज बेसिकली अ कलेक्शन ऑफ डिजिटल डेटाबेसेस रिलेटेड टू द फार्मर्स इन एग्रीकल्चर. एंड इट विल बेसिकली बी अ प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर ऑल द एंड टू एंड सर्विसेज विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द फार्मर्स इन द डिजिटल मोड. ओके एंड फॉर दैट अ यूनिक आइडेंटिटी नंबर विल बी गिवन टू ऑल द फार्मर्स with the help of which they can access all the information related to the agriculture and the other services. Okay, so Microsoft is the correct answer, option B. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope aapko ye session acha laga hoga. And agar aapko ye sessions acche lagte hain to inko aur acche se padhte jao, inko revise karte jao. Aur ESI current ka bahut bada role hota hai in the RBI grade B exam and the NABARD exam. So ESI current affairs को आपको हल्के में नहीं लेना है. And remember you have to comment your marks also. अपने marks जरूर comment करना, भूलना मत. Thank you so much for watching. मिलते हैं Friday के session में with the very brand new session of PIB 247. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.